وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
Now in the second segment of our lecture, inshallah ta'ala, we're going to take صور من عبادة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. We're going to take four examples or four points to indicate and show for the listeners, inshallah ta'ala, the ibadah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The first thing I'm going to start with is wudu'un Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's wudu'. Humran, Mawla Uthman ibn Affan. Humran was a slave boy of Uthman ibn Affan. He said, أنه رأى عثمان بن عفان دعا بإناء. He saw عثمان بن عفان رضي الله تعالى عنه call for a utensil. بإناء. فأفرغ على كفيه ثلاث مرار فغسلهما. He called for a utensil. And عثمان رضي الله عنه then washed the water with his hands three times. So he washed his hands first. Uthman radiallahu anhu cleaned his hands. As you can see from here, cleaning your hands before you even do wudu. And cleaning your hands after you wake up and cleaning your hands before you sleep, all of them is from the sunnah of the Prophet. The Prophet he said, إِذَا اسْتَيْقَظَ أَحَدُكُم مِّن نَوْمِهِ. If one of you wakes up from his sleep, he should not place his hands inside the utensils. Don't put your hands inside places. فَإِنَّهُ لَا يَدْرِي أَيْنَ بَاتَتْ يَدُهُ. Because you don't know where your hand was last night. What places it grabbed and it touched. You were sleeping. You wouldn't know. So Islam gives so much importance to hygiene and cleaning your hands. It's not something that we're taking from the West and this virus. Is not what's teaching us how to wash our hands and the importance of washing hands. It's something we already believed and our religion has already stated. And our Prophet ﷺ emphasized on that. على كل حال, Uthman رضي الله عنه, he called for water, it was brought to him, and what did he do? فأفرغ على كفيه ثلاث مرار فغسلهما. He washed it three times. ثم أدخل يمينه في الإناء. And then what he did was he took his right hand and he placed it inside the utensil. فَمَضْمَضَ وَاسْتَنْشَقَ. Uthman رضي الله عنه, what did he do? فَمَضْمَضَ وَاسْتَنْشَقَ. He took the water, he put it into his mouth. يعني فَمَضْمَضَ. He ran the water into his mouth. He rinsed his mouth. And he also placed water in his nose. ثُمَّ غَسَلَ وَجْهَهُ ثَلَاثًا. And he washed his face, all of it, three times. Uthman رضي الله عنه. Okay? And then وَيَدَيْهِ, his hands, إِلَى الْمِرْفِقَيْنِ, يعني مَعَ الْمِرْفِقَيْنِ, he washed it with his elbows. He added the elbows in what he washed. He did this how many times? ثَلَاثَ مِرَارٍ. He did it three times. ثُمَّ مَسَحَ بِرَأْسِهِ, and then he wiped his hair. He didn't wash it, he wiped it. So he did it once. ثُمَّ رِجِلَيْهِ, and then he washed. ثم غسل رجليه, then he washed his two legs ثلاثة مرار, three times. إلى الكعبين, and he did it up to the ankles. He made sure he washed the heels as well. ثم قال, and then after that he said, من توضأ نحو وضوء هذا. Ponder here. After doing that, عثمان رضي الله عنه, he said, قال قال رسول الله, the messenger said, من توضأ نحو وضوء هذا. The Prophet said, anyone who does like this wudu I did for you. Uthman said, the wudu I did for you right now, anyone who does the likes of this wudu. ثم صلى ركعتين, and then he prays two rak'ah. لا يحدث فيهما نفسه, and he doesn't talk to himself, he doesn't whisper to himself. غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. His sins that he's done in the past are forgiven for him. This is the wudu of the Prophet. This is the first ibadah that we have to understand. Look how our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam cleaned himself and how he did his wudu alayhi salatu wa sallam. And then he legislated right after it. Salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi. What did he legislate? He legislated what is known as sunnatul wudu. Sunnatul wudu is what? It's the sunnah that you pray after you've done your wudu. Again, that's something we're going to work hard on, inshallah ta'ala, to make sure that we implement it. So if you do that, you do the wudu the way that Uthman radiallahu anhu showed the companions. Okay? If you do it like that, and then you stand up and you pray two rak'ah, and you don't talk to yourself, you don't whisper to yourself, you don't have waswas or anything like that. Okay? You do khushu', you ponder over what you're reciting. غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِ. Your sins that you have done before will be forgiven for you. مُتَّفَقٌ عَلَيْهِ. The hadith is narrated in Bukhari and Muslim, and it's one of the hadiths that Abdul Ghani ibn Abdul Wahid al-Maqdisi brought in his kitab Umdatul Hakam. The second example I want to show regarding the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's ibadah is his salah. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's salah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he implemented the ayah where Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said to him, وَمِنَ اللَّيْلِ فَتَهَجَّتْ بِهِ نَافِلَةً لَكَ عَسَىٰ أَن يَبْعَثَكَ رَبُّكَ مَقَامًا مَحْمُودًا. This ayah, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is addressing the Prophet. فَتَهَجَّتْ بِهِ. Pray the night prayer. عَسَىٰ أَن يَبْعَثَكَ رَبُّكَ مَقَامًا مَحْمُودًا. And Allah will give you مَقَامًا مَحْمُودًا, the praiseworthy station. And our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam implemented that verse and made sure he prayed that prayer. Our mother Aisha tells us how he implemented that verse. Our mother Aisha, she said, أن نبي الله محمد, our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, كان يقوم من الليل. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to stand up at night عليه الصلاة والسلام, حتى تتفطرت قدمه, حتى تتفطر قدمه. He would pray until his two feet would swell. That's Nabiullah Muhammad. The Prophet's ibadah was so much so that he would pray, and he would pray until his legs, they would be swollen. فقالت عائشة, عائشة, she said, لما تصنع هذا يا رسول الله. Oh Messenger of Allah, why are you doing this to yourself? Why are you doing this to yourself? وقد غفر الله لك ما تقدم من ذنبك وما تأخر. And Allah has forgiven you for your past and your upcoming sins, for any shortcomings. You've been forgiven for it. That to come and that which is past, you're forgiven. Then the Messenger responded and he said, أَفَلَا أُحِبُّ أَنْ أَكُونَ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا. Would I not love to be? Would I not love to be a slave who shows gratitude to his Lord? يعني, when Aisha said to him, Allah has forgiven you for your past sins and your upcoming sins, he said, then why should I not show gratitude to that Lord? Look at how he's thinking, alayhi salatu wasalam. Look how much he loves the concept of worshipping Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Because he said, أَفَلَا أُحِبُّ. Do I not love for me to be what? أَنْ أَكُونَ عَبْدًا. For me to be a slave. شَكُورًا. A slave who shows gratitude to his Lord. So Nabiullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to pray a lot. And his prayer was long. It was lengthy. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud tells us about the Prophet's salah. Bukhari and Muslim both narrated that Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he said, صَلَّيْتُ لَيْلَةً مَعَ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ. One night, I prayed with the Prophet. فَلَمْ يَزَلْ قَائِمًا حَتَّى هَمَمْتُ بِأَمْرِ سُوءٍ حَتَّى هَمَمْتُ بِأَمْرٍ سُوءٍ. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he said, one night I prayed with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَلَمْ يَزَلْ قَائِمًا. The Prophet was standing up and he was praying and he was praying and he was praying, alayhi salatu wasalam. And a thought came to my mind. Yani the salah was so long, the duration was too long, that I thought to myself, let me do something very bad. هَمَمْتُ بِأَمْرٍ سُوءٍ. I thought of doing something very evil. And that was what? قِيلَ لَهُ. These people, they said to him, What was it that you were going to do? وَمَا هَمَمْتَ بِهِ What was it that came to your mind that you wanted to do? What was the evil thing that you wanted to do? He said, هَمَمْتُ أَنْ أَقْعُدَ وَأَدَعَ النَّبِيَّ The evil thing that came to my mind was, I wanted to sit down and leave the Prophet ﷺ. يعني I wanted to leave the prayer. Two things we take from this hadith. Number one, the Messenger ﷺ's ibadah was that long. And it was that much that a noble companion like Abdullah ibn Mas'ud couldn't keep up with the Prophet. Alayhi salatu wasalam. And Abdullah ibn Mas'ud was much younger than the Prophet. Alayhi salatu wasalam. The second thing that we take from the hadith is Abdullah ibn Mas'ud considered it something evil to walk away from praying with the Prophet. Alayhi salatu wasalam. Hudhayfa ibn al-Yaman radiyallahu ta'ala anhu is going to explain to us in details how the Qiyam al-Layl of the Prophet used to be. So we have an understanding of a Prophet of Allah who's been forgiven all of his sins, how he's praying at night. So Hudhayfa ibn al-Yaman radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he explains to us and tells us the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam salah. Yani Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, what made him feel like he wanted to do something evil and leave the prayer? Let Hudhayfa ibn al-Yaman tell us how it was like. Hudhayfa ibn al-Yaman mentioned, as Imam al-Muslim narrated in his Sahih, he said, "Sallaytu ma'an Nabi." I also prayed with the Prophet. Hudhayfa also prayed with the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And when Hudhayfa radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he prayed with the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, صليتُ مع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ذات ليلة فافتتح سورة البقرة. He said, I prayed with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم one night, and he started سورة البقرة. فقلت, I said to myself, يركع عند المئة. When he reaches 100, he's going to stop, and he's going to do his ركوع. ثم مضى. He carried on. فقلت, I then said to myself, okay, he's going to يصلي. He will pray with it. بِهَا فِي رَكْعَةٍ Maybe Baqarah would be one rak'ah. Keep in mind, Baqarah is how long? Baqarah is two juz and something. And he's saying that after I realized that he's going far, I then said to myself, maybe he's going to finish Suratul Baqarah. Allahu Akbar. He finished Baqarah. ثُمَّ افْتَتَحَ النِّسَاء And then he opened Suratul Nisa. This, the scholars, they took from it that the Prophet didn't go to Ali Imran. He went to what? Suratul Nisa. And that you can change the order. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam finished Baqarah. And then he started Suratul Nisa. فقرأها. He recited it. ثم افتتح النساء. Hudhayfa salam in the prayer. He finished Suratul Nisa, all of it. And then he started what? He started Ali Imran. فقرأها. He recited it. That's five juz and something. في ركعة واحدة in one ركعة. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is praying it. Now question. Five juz, was it fast? No. Hudhayfa radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, يقرأها مترسلا. He was reciting it. The way that the Prophet was reciting it was مترسل. He was reciting a مترسل. مترسل here is what? إذا مر بآية فيها تسبيح سبح. If he came across a verse that Allah was exalted, he exalted him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِذَا مَرَّ And if he went by a verse, وَإِذَا مَرَّ بِسُؤَالٍ If he came by a verse where he wanted to supplicate to Allah, he will supplicate to Allah. سَأَلَ وَإِذَا مَرَّ بِتَعَوُّذٍ تَعَوَّذَ And if he came across, if he passed by a verse where it was talking about عذاب النار and this, he will seek refuge in Allah from it. This is what this noble companion saw. ثُمَّ And after that, ثُمَّ رَكَعَ فَجَعَلَ يَقُولُ سُبْحَانَ رَبِّيَ الْعَظِيمِ And then he went into ruku' and he would say, سُبْحَانَ رَبِّيَ الْعَظِيمِ فَكَانَ رُكُوعُهُ نَحْوًا مِّنْ قِيَامِ And his ruku' was close to, but like he's standing. And his ruku' was as long as five juz. Imagine that, close to that. ثُمَّ قَالَ And then he said, سَمِعَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ حَمِدَهُ The Prophet said, ثم قام طويلا قريبا. He stood up. صلى الله عليه وسلم. عليه الصلاة والسلام. He stood up in that position for long. Close to what? قريبا مما ركع. Close to his ركوع. When he went into sujood, he said سبحان ربي الأعلى. فكان سجوده قريبا من قيامه. And his sujood was close to his standing from the ركوع. When he got up from the ركوع, the standing that he stood, the sujood was close to that. يعني the Prophet's recitation of those five juz for حذيفة بن اليمان على عبد الله بن مسعود was very, very long. ولذلك the Prophet condemned people recite the Quran fast. Like that's how he hated it عليه الصلاة والسلام. And he mentioned سيخرج أقوام من أمتي. A group of people are going to come from my ummah. يشربون القرآن كشربهم اللبن. And they're going to drink the Quran like they drink milk. And they're going to go fast. Tabarani narrated in his Mu'jam min hadith Uqbah ibn Amir. There's going to come a people, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying, what are they going to do? Yashrabun al-Qur'an. They're going to drink the Quran. And they're going to go fast in the recitation of the Quran, kashurbihim al-laban, the way that they drink milk. Walidhalika Umar radiyallahu anhu, he said wa sharru al-qira'ati al-hadrama. The worst type of recitation is Al-Hadrama. Al-Hadrama means what? It's the recitation where you fast in your reading. Nabi Muhammad Salah and his Ibadah, he never had that type of recitation. He didn't. ولذلك the scholars and the Imams, like Imam Al-Iraqi and others, they spoke about it. That the recitation like that, it's not only condemned for the Quran, it's also condemned for the Hadith. Like when you're reading the Hadith. ولذلك عراقي, he says in his نظم شر القراءة إذا ما هدرما. The worst of قراءة is إذا ما هدرما. This is when he was talking about how do you write the hadiths. ويكره الخط الدقيق إلا لضيق رق أو لراحل فلا وشره التعليق والمشق كما شر القراءة إذا ما هدرما. He said the worst of قراءة is what? إذا ما هدرما. If a person recites it too fast. ولذلك عبد الله بن مسعود, he used to say ولا تهدو هد الشعر. Do not recite the Quran the way you recite the poetry. The poetry, the way that they used to recite it was very fast. They would eat the words. Don't recite the Quran like that. So what should we do? قفوا عند عجائبي. Stand over the fascination and the amazing things in the Quran. Stand over those things. وحركوا به القلوب. Move your hearts with it when you're reciting it. ولا يكون, he said, don't let it be. ولا يكون هم أحدكم آخر الصورة. Do not let one of you make his aspiration. All he's looking for is the ending of the surah. When am I going to finish the surah? When am I going to finish the Quran? When am I going to finish the Quran? Don't do that. So the Prophet's recitation of his قيام الليل was كان يقطع قراءته آية الآية. And he would cut it آية آية. And he would stand يقف على رؤوس الآية. He would stand in each ayah. He wouldn't say الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم. He wouldn't do that. He would say الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين. Like he would cut each one. And قتادة بن دعامة السدوسي, he said سألت أنس بن مالك. I went to أنس بن مالك and I asked him عن قراءتي النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. I asked the Prophet ﷺ recitation, how was it like? He said كان يمد صوته مدا. That the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he would lengthen صلوات الله وسلامه عليه, he would lengthen and he would prolong the places that required يفعلون. Like he would صلوات الله وسلامه عليه. And then what we take from this, my beloved brothers and sisters, is عبد الله بن مسعود did not just, and حذيفة بن اليمان, they did not just pray with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam a salah where he prayed only five ajza. It wasn't just like that. Rather, the five juz that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam prayed, it's five juz that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam كان يمد صوته مدا. He's doing the mad that's needed. كان يقطع قراءته آية آية. He's cutting each verse from the other verse and he's breathing after he finishes each ayah. He's also what? مترسلا. He's reciting it. إذا مر بآية فيها تصبيح سبح. If he came across a verse that there was a tasbih, he needs to exalt Allah, he exalts him. وَإِذَا مَرَّ بِسُؤَالٍ, if he wants to supplicate to Allah, سَأَلَ, he supplicates to him. وَإِذَا مَرَّ بِتَعَوُّدٍ تَعَوَّذَ, and if he wants to seek refuge in Allah from something, he seeks refuge in Allah from it. That was his recitation, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now ponder. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's legs, they swelled. حَتَّى تَتَفَطَّرَ قَدَمَهُ, his legs, they swollen from the prayer of the Prophet, from his prayer, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because of how he used to recite. So we need to understand that we're not forgiven for our sins. We are nowhere close to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we take it very lightly when it comes to our ibadat. May Allah make us from those who strengthen their ibadat and follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in that regard. Now inshaAllah ta'ala, I'm going to speak about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's fasting. And how was his fasting alayhi salatu wasalam? We've now understood how his wudu was and how his salah was. We've got two more to go inshaAllah ta'ala. How the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's fasting was and how his dhikr was, the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Abdullah ibn Abbas narrated, he said, مَا صَامَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ شَهْرًا كَامِلًا قَطُّ غَيْرَ رَمَضَانٍ, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never fasted a complete month except Ramadan. وَيَصُومُ حَتَّى يَقُولَ الْقَائِلُ, and he would fast that month, other Ramadan of course, he would fast that month until a person would say to himself, لا والله لا يفطر حتى يقول القائل لا والله لا يصوم. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he would fast until a person would say لا والله لا يفطر, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would not break his fast. And he would do that sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لا والله لا يفطر حتى يقول القائل لا والله لا يصوم. And he would break his fast until a person says the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will never fast. Ya'ani, what it shows you here is that he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was a person who used to fast a lot. ولذلك, we took before that Abu Huraira, he said, Awsani Khalili, my close friend, Nabiullahi Muhammad, advised me three things. And from the three things that he advised him was number one, أن يصوم ثلاثة أيام من كل شهر, that he fast 3 days from every month. Anas ibn Malik, he said, كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يفطر من الشهر حتى نظن أن لا يصوم منه ويصوم حتى نظن أن لا يفطر منه شيئا, وكان لا نشاء تراه من الليل مصليا إلا رأيته ولا نائما إلا رأيته, أخرجه البخاري. Anas ibn Malik, he said that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to fast in the month until we will say to ourselves, أَلَّا يَصُومَ مِنْهُ, that he's not going to fast. وَيَصُومَ, and he will fast, حَتَّى نَظُنَّ أَلَّا يُفْطِرَ, and he will fast until we say to ourselves, نَبِي اللَّهِ مُحَمَّدٍ, is not going to break his fast. يعني, he used to balance his fasting. صَلَوَاتُ اللَّهِ وَسَلَامٌ عَلَيْهِ. وَلِذَلِكَ, the famous hadith of Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha fi sahihain in Bukhari and Muslim, كان إذا دخل عشر الأواخر, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was one that if the last 10 nights of Ramadan entered, he would do the following. He would, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, شد مئزره, he would tight his waist, وأحيا ليلته, and he would revive his night, وأيقظ أهله, and he would wake his family up to indulge with him in the good that he wants to do. He wants them to help him and to work with him in the good that he is doing. لأن the believers, they help one another in good. When they do it, they encourage one another. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he used to fast in some of the months until we would think to ourselves, he will never break his fast. يعني, this shows how excessive his fasting was, alayhi salatu wasalam. And now we're going to move on to the second form of ibadah that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam used to do that we can take a benefit from, inshallah ta'ala, which is dhikrullah, the remembrance of Allah. Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala instructed the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to remember Allah in every situation. Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, he said to him, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَذْكُرْ رَبَّكَ فِي نَفْسِكَ تَضَرُّعًا وَخِيفَةً وَذْكُرْ Remember Muhammad. رَبَّكَ your Lord فِي نَفْسِكَ تَضَرُّعًا وَخِيفَةً وَدُونَ الْجَهْرِ مِنَ الْقَوْلِ بِالْغُدُوِ وَالْأَصَالِ وَلَا تَكُمْ مِنَ الْغَافِلِينَ Remember your Lord privately, publicly. Remember him. And do not be from the heedless ones. Remember your Lord. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because he was instructed by Allah to remember him every situation, privately or publicly, the Messenger did that. ولذلك عائشة mentioned, as Imam Muslim narrated in Sahih, كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يذكر الله على كل أحيانه. That the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he used to remember Allah in all of his situations. Because Allah commanded him in the ayah. صلوات الله وسلامه عليه. الأغر المزني رضي الله تعالى عنه, he said that the Prophet said, إنه ليغان على قلبي. That the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, a veil will be placed over my heart. The Prophet saying this. إنه ليغان على قلبي. My heart, a veil will be placed on it. The Prophet saying this عليه الصلاة والسلام. على قلبي وإني لأستغفر الله في اليوم 100 مرة. And I ask Allah for forgiveness every day 100 times. Yani the Prophet is saying to you, a veil is placed on my heart, and then what I do is, I ask Allah for forgiveness every day 100 times. Allahu Akbar. Nabiullahi Muhammad, asking Allah for forgiveness 100 times a day. Astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, he's saying, alayhi salatu wasalam. This shows us that he was one who remembered Allah a lot. Why would he not be? He was the one who instructed his companions to remember Allah a lot. A man came to him. He said, Ya Rasulullah, inna shara'i' al-Islami qad kathurat. The legislations of al-Islam has become too much on me. Tell me shay'un atashabbathu bih. Give me one thing within the religion that I can hold on to. Something I can hold on to. The legislations are too much. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, La yaza'alu lisanaka ratban min dhikrillah. Do not let your tongue dry from the remembrance of Allah. Always remember Allah. Keep the remembrance of Allah on your tongue. Because the remembrance of Allah does not have a time. وَكُنْ ذَاكِرًا لِلَّهِ فِي كُلِّ حَالَةٍ فَلَيْسَ لِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَقْتٌ مُقَيَّدٌ Be a person who remembers Allah a lot. For verily, the remembrance of Allah, it hasn't got a restricted time. You remember Allah in every situation. وَلِذَلِكَ وَوَصَّى مُعَاذًا يَسْتَعِينُ إِلَهَهُ بِأَنَّ كَثِيرَ الذِّكْرِ فِي السَّبْقِ مُفْرِدُ مُعَاذِ بْنُ جَبَلٍ رضي الله تعالى عنه, the Prophet advised him. صلوات الله وسلامه عليه. And he advised him what? He advised him to say after every salah, اللَّهُمَّ أَعِنِّي عَلَى ذِكْرِكَ وَشُكْرِكَ وَحُسْنُ عِبَادَتِكَ. He said, Wallahi inni la uhibbuk, Mu'adh, I love you. Do not leave off saying after every single salah, Allahumma a'inni ala dhikrika wa shukrika wa husni ibadatik. Oh Allah, aid me and support me. In what? A'inni ala dhikrika, in your remembrance. A'inni ala dhikrika wa shukrika, and showing you gratitude. Oh Allah, help me. Give me the ability to show you gratitude. Wa husni ibadatik. And for me to perfect my ibadah. So Mu'adh ibn Jabal is being taught to remember Allah after every salah. وَلِذَلِكَ عَبْدَ الرَّحْمَنِ ibn Nasir al-Sa'diyu, he mentioned some benefits of the dhikr. I'm going to read it on you. Sa'diyu rahimahullah, he said in his kitab Manhajul al-Haq, he said, وَكُنْ ذَاكِرًا لِلَّهِ فِي كُلِّ حَالَةٍ فليس لذكر الله وقت مقيد فذكر إله العرش سرا ومعلنا يزيل الشقى والهم عنك ويطرده ويجلب للخيرات دنيا وآجلا وإن يأتك الوسواس يوما يشرد. He said, be a person who remembers Allah all the time. وكن ذاكرا لله في كل حالة. Remember Allah in all situations. For verily, the remembrance of Allah doesn't have a restricted time. The remembrance of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, what does it do? Remembering Him privately and publicly, what does it do? يُزِيلُ الشَّقَى وَالْهَمَّ عَنْكَ وَيَطْرُدُ. It gets rid of distress. By remembering Allah, you repel distress and anxiety, sadness and depression. وَيَجْلِبُ لِلْخَيْرَاتِ دُنْيًا وَآجِلًا. And it brings you good in this world. The good will come your way. وَإِنْ يَأْتِكَ الْوَسْوَاسُ يَوْمًا يُشَرِّدُ. And if whispers of shaitan comes to you, it gets rid of it and it destroys it. فَقَدْ أَخْبَرَ الْمُخْتَارُ يَوْمًا لِصَحْبِهِ. The Prophet ﷺ one day said to his companions, بِأَنَّ كَثِيرَ الذِّكْرِ فِي السَّبْقِ مُفْرِدُ. The Prophet told them, سَبَقَ الْمُفَرِّدُونَ. The Mufarridun have passed everybody. And so the Sahaba, they said, who are the Mufarridun, O Messenger of Allah? And he said, أَذَّاكِرُونَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا وَالذَّاكِرَاتِ. It is the men and the female who remember Allah a lot. They've passed everybody else. فَقَدْ أَخْبَرَ الْمُخْتَارُ يَوْمًا لِصَحْبِهِ بِأَنَّ كَثِيرَ الذِّكْرِ فِي السَّبْقِ مُفْرِدُ وَوَصَّى مُعَاذًا يَسْتَعِينُ إِلَهُ عَلَى ذِكْرِ وَالشُّكْرِ بِالْحُسْنِ يَعْبُدُ. And the Prophet advised Mu'adh ibn Jabal to say the following, اللَّهُمَّ أَعِنِّي عَلَى ذِكْرِكَ وَشُكْرِكَ وَحُسْنِ عِبَادَتِكَ وَأَوْصَى لِشَخْصٍ قَدْ أَتَى لِنَصِيحَةٍ. And he advised a man who came to him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who asked for an advice. وَقَدْ كَانَ فِي حَمْلِ الشَّرَائِعِ يَجْهَدُ. And this man was struggling with the legislation of the Sharia. The Prophet advised him. What did he advise him? بِأَلَّا يَزَلْ رَطْبَ لِسَانُكَ هَذِي. Do not let this tongue of yours dry. Don't let it dry. هَذِي تُعِينُ عَلَى أُمُورِ وَتُسْعِدُ. It will bring you happiness. It will aid you and support you in everything. وَأَخْبَرَ أَنَّ الذِّكْرَ غَرْسٌ لِأَهْلِهِ. The Prophet also told us that in the remembrance of Allah, it's like planting a seed for its people. In where لكن بِجَنَّاتِ عَدْنٍ وَالْمَسَاكِنُ تُمْهَدُ. يعني the remembrance of Allah is a plant and seeds that you are planting in your place in Jannah. وَأَخْبَرَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَذْكُرُ عَبَدَهُ. And Allah remembers you. فِي الْمَلَأِ الْأَعْلَى. If you remember Allah on this earth, Allah will remember you in a place better than where you are remembering Him. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَعَهُ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ الْأُمُورِ يُسَدِّدُ. And in all of your affairs, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will make it easy, smooth and good. وَأَخْبَرَ أَنَّ الذِّكْرَ يَبْقَى بِجَنَّةٍ وَيَنْقَطْعُ التَّكْلِيفُ حِينًا يُخَلَّدُ. Your other righteous deeds, they come to an end. But the remembrance of Allah is an ongoing righteous thing. Even after you're gone. This is some of the benefits that he mentioned. Al-Allama Abdulrahman Nasir al-Saudi in his kitab Manhaj al-Haq. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in all of these situations, he's encouraging his companions to be ones that remember Allah a lot. This, inshallah ta'ala, brings me to the end of the second part of my lecture. I finished the introduction and I've spoken about three principles and foundations in the introduction. And then I spoke about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and how his ibadah was. And I spoke about it from four perspectives. His wudu, and his salah, and his fasting, and the last one, which was his dhikr of Allah azza wa jalla. In my next inshallah ta'ala segment, I'm going to be speaking about the ibadah of the salafus salih, the ibadah of the early generation. And I'm going to be speaking about that in 21 different ways of how their ibadah was, inshallah ta'ala, and how they enjoyed their ibadah and the ladha that they got from it. Inshallah ta'ala, see you there, bi-ibnillahi al-kareem.
Assalamu alaikum. If you're enjoying these videos and you'd like to keep up to date with all of the courses we're going to be running, make sure you head over to amau@home.com.